the beautiful island of Kauai. You know when you're in a location and it makes you feel a certain way? That feeling for me is a feeling called home. Doesn't matter if you've lived there for years or are visiting for the first time, you feel it. There's that beautiful magic. For me, it's the 85 degree warm hug, the calming sounds of water movement all around, not to mention the familiar sounds of roosters, like the ones in the Philippines that instantly transport me to my forever home there. It's the million shades of green and that smell of fresh rain and bug spray. Mosquitoes and I have the same taste and environment, apparently. The locals feel like family, even if they walk on four legs. You can't help but ask yourself, is this what heaven on earth looks and feels like? It has that perfect balance of slow tranquility and crazy excitement. Everywhere you look, something beautiful makes you hope you're not just dreaming. So it hurts my heart when I see plastic washing up on its pristine shores. The reality of humanity sets in. A burning sense of sadness and anger fill my insides when I look up and see more down the beach. This reminds me why atola is named after a marine animal. There's a greater mission than just showing off cinematic travel B-roll and throwing on some inspiring music. There's another side to every travel destination that people don't want to see or even talk about. Most of these plastics we only use one time, and they end up in waterways too. In the middle of the ocean, there's this giant floating island of garbage. It's pretty nasty. It's so large now that it ranges from the size of Texas and can grow to the size of Russia. It's called the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. I'm not the type of person to say that this doesn't affect me, ignore it, and move on. The ocean is just a sacred place for me, and I respect it. I wanna keep places like Hawaii and the Philippines and other places beautiful. I wanna save the sea turtles and other marine life. I'm hoping that there's just one other person out there, somewhere out there that also feels the same. If you do, emoji your favorite ocean creature in the comments below. Mine will be down there as well. I'll see you. I immediately took a break from my vacation to find an ocean cleanup organization. We found out Surf Rider was doing a cleanup, luckily, when we were in town.
So far this year, we have almost 80,000 pounds of marine debris, which includes nets, plastic waste, any kind of trash that washes up. Last year, we did about 124,000 pounds, and we're on track to beat that this year.
Not only did we get to enjoy this beautiful secret beach that we didn't even know existed, but we found crazy things lying around. Like this 70-pound propane tank that took three people to carry it up to the truck. Just in a couple hours and with about 15 people, we filled a whole truck full of netting, tires, and other crazy things. Even umbrellas. It makes me so happy seeing other businesses change their ways, even if they're just changing their straws. For anyone to change things at home, here's some ideas. Switch your everyday things that can last longer and that can decompose faster than 1,000 years. Reusable water bottles, bulk buy and refill products, such as dry goods, soaps and shampoos, even pens. Shave with a double-edged razor. These blades are actually cheaper than using cartridges. Bamboo toothbrushes, compostable doggy poop bags for my dog parents out there, electric lighters, and wax wraps instead of plastic wrap. Now, no one is telling you to be 100% plastic free, but even noticing makes a huge difference. Thank you for listening to my PSA and let me know in the comments below how you mitigate plastics. So let's keep this planet feeling like home so you can enjoy and shoot more travel videos to come. Thanks for hanging out with me. Find me on IG because I post there on the daily. You do you, fam, and I'll see you when I see you. Done. Ugh.